Okay, good afternoon, everybody. So in today's class, we are going to study the temperature. Means we have a different units of temperature. One is degree Celsius, one is degree Fahrenheit, as well as it will go. One of the most important SI unit of temperature, standard international unit of temperature, is Kelvin scale. What is that, Mari? Kelvin.
Kelvin scale.
So in today's
Kelvin scale.
Yeah, I will teach you to convert understanding from what to means from degree Celsius to Fahrenheit, Fahrenheit to degree Celsius, as well as degree Celsius to Kelvin, Kelvin to Fahrenheit, like that and all I will discuss. Is it okay, Mari? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Hari?
Yes, sir.
In this class, we are going to study only the one that is called as understanding conversion. All of you keep reading. Keep reading.
Conversion of temperature.
Yeah, how to convert heading, you can, or else you can keep conversion of units, conversion of temperature. It is not coming, Mari, just wait a minute.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in today's class, we are going to study very understanding only one thing, that is called as understanding temperature of units and how to convert one unit to another unit. That's, is it okay, Ra?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You can keep temperature, conversion of temperature, conversion of
temperature, temperature.
Yeah, units of temperature. Is it okay, Mari?
Yes, sir.
So, yes, sir. 0 to 1. Okay. 0 1 0 0 1. 2021. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start now. So as we know that, please tell me what units of temperature. Remember, Mari and everybody. So the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. What is that?
Kelvin.
Which we used to represent with only capital K, no degree, no degree. Do you understand it? And other units.
Yes, sir.
So other units of temperature, which is equals to degree Celsius. What is that?
Degree Celsius and Fahrenheit, degree Fahrenheit.
Represent, understanding like the, and the name is what, Mari? Hari? Degree
Fahrenheit.
Degree Fahrenheit, which is represented with like this. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we start now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
One minute. Fahrenheit spelling you learn. What is the Fahrenheit spelling? F-A-H-H-E-I-T. Understand? Here I missed it. That is why I kept here. Okay, Ra? F-A-H.
Yes, sir. F-A-R-E-N. Fahrenheit.
First, let us study. Understand? Conversion of degree Celsius to. Conversion of.
Degree
Celsius.
Degree Celsius to.
Kelvin.
Okay.
So now let us come to here. So as we know that if we'll take the Kelvin scale, basically, if we'll take the Kelvin scale, observe very carefully. So Kelvin scale, it will start with, remember, starts with 0 degree Celsius. How much it is?
0 degree Celsius.
Celsius scale. This is called as Celsius scale.
So Celsius.
Celsius scale starts with 0 degrees and ends with 100 degrees. Is it okay, Mari?
100 degrees.
No, as
yes,
I'm saying you, the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. Hari, observe very carefully. Kelvin scale will start with 273, yes. Understand, 273 Kelvin and ends with, understand, plus 373 Kelvin.
It was,
and ends with what, Mari? 373 Kelvin.
Yes, sir.
So now, when I say that 0 degree Celsius is equals to 273 Kelvin, 100 degree Celsius is equals to 373 Kelvin. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
So the conversion between the Celsius scale and the Kelvin scale is 0 degree Celsius, which is equals to 273 Kelvin. Note it down, all of it. 0 degree Celsius is equals to 273 Kelvin. Do you understand, Mari?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, for example, let us take example. Kaushik, why you are using that animator, eh? Okay, I will unmute. I will make it disabled. Now observe, Mari, all of you hurry. So let us say, for example, I have given 10 degree Celsius, which is equals to dash Kelvin. That is what our answer. Is it okay, Mari? That is our question. Hurry, Kaushik. Now observe very carefully. So 10 degree Celsius, how I can write? 10 degree Celsius, how I can write? 10 degree Celsius, how I can write?
So 10 degree Celsius is equal to 272 degree.
10 degree
Celsius. 272.
10 into degree Celsius. Is it yes or no, Mari?
Yes, sir. 10 into degree Celsius.
Huh? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
As we know that, observe this scale carefully. 0 is equals to 273 Kelvin. Like that. 1 degree equals to how much? Hari, can you able to say?
273. 273 degree Celsius. 273
degree is equal to 273 degree Celsius.
So here one reading. Here one small division is equal to how much? Each small
division. That means 274.
So here one small division is equal to plus 1 you have to add. So now this I can write. 1 degree Celsius is equal to how much?
274. 274 degree Celsius.
Okay, hurry.
Okay, sir.
Plus 1 we should add.
Yes, sir, I can
understand. Observe very carefully here. What will come? 10 degree Celsius I can write.
Okay.
10 into 1 degree Celsius. So means in the sense of 1 degree Celsius is equal to how much? 10 plus 273.
Yes, sir.
24, which is equal to how much? 284 Kelvin. Is it yes or no? Is it
yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Huh?
Sir, instead of into, you wrote plus, sir.
Into not. It is a plus. Oh, sorry. It is plus. That is what? Sorry. Wrong it is. So, you have to add. Just add. That's all, Mari. Nothing is there. So, we should add 10 degrees means, 10 degrees Celsius means, we should add 10 plus 273. That's all. 1 degree means 1 plus 273. Like that, 10 degrees means 10 plus 273. Like that, we should add. 10 degrees means what we should add? 10 plus 273. Do you understand, Mari? Which is equals to 283. Is it understanding? 283 Kelvin. Is it okay, Hari?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, I can't understand, sir.
2 degree Celsius means, remember, 2 plus 273 Kelvin. That's all, Mari. So, which is equals to 275 Kelvin. Is it okay, Mari? So, 2 degree Celsius is equals to
275. Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Ask me.
Sir, you wrote 10 degree Celsius is equal to dash Kelvin, no, sir.
10 plus 273.
So, first step you have to...
that multiplication...
10 not plus... You wrote...
Just we have to add 273 every time. That's all. Okay, Mari?
273, yeah, sir.
273 we have to add. Suppose you see, I have given 50 degree Celsius. What you will do, tell me? 50 degree Celsius is equal to Hari. Can you able to say? This is the second example. What we have to do? 50 plus 273 Kelvin. That's all. Which is equals to how much? Which is equals to how much, Mari? 300 and add it.
Contents.
300 and how much? 273 plus 50. 200 and?
Sir, 323. 323.
Understand, Mari? Not understood.
323, sir.
Yeah, I can understand. Yes, sir, I can understand, sir.
Now you see, Mari, 0 degrees equals how much, Mari? 0 degrees equals to 273 Kelvin.
0 degrees equal to 273, sir. Yes, sir. 0 into 273, sir.
Observe very carefully. For example, more in detail will go. So let us observe carefully. 0 degrees Celsius, 100 degrees Celsius. So how many divisions are there middle? 100 divisions. Is it yes or no?
100 divisions. Yes, sir.
Each small division is
0.1, sir.
100, each small division is equal
to... Sir. Yes, sir, 100.
each
one degree Celsius.
Now, same way Kelvin scale. All of you understand Kelvin scale also 270 Kelvin first. Next, 100 divisions are there. 100 divisions are there. Up we have 373 Kelvin. So means in the sense of each small division, how much Mari here? Hari, small division. Small division is equal to how much?
Here, one Kelvin.
That's all,
one
Mari.
Kelvin. Yes, sir.
Now, in Celsius scale, temperature increases one division. So in Kelvin scale also, temperature will increase how much? One division only. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
In Celsius scale, temperature increases to two divisions. In Kelvin scale also increases how much? Two divisions. Because number of divisions is equal. Yes. So here one small division is equals to 1 degree Celsius. Here one small division is equals to one Kelvin. Do you understand it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is why I can say. So understanding 0 degree Celsius is equals to 273 Kelvin as well as 100 degree Celsius is equals to 373 Kelvin. Is it yes or no? That is what we are finding in the scales. Correct or not? So this top one.
Yes, sir, I can understand, sir.
Is equal and bottom one is equal. So what is the melting point of water? Can you able to say, Mari and Hari? Anybody?
0 degree Celsius, sir.
0 degree is equal to Kelvin 273 degree. Melting point of water, melting point of ice, which is equals to 0 degree Celsius. Or can I write which is equals to 273 Kelvin? Can I write it or not?
Yes, sir.
That is what you should remember. Is it okay, Hari? Are you understanding, Hari?
Yes, sir. I can understand.
So now, let's say if we'll take boiling point of water, Kaushik, boiling point of water, which is equal to how much?
Which is equal 100 degree Celsius, sir. Or 373 degree.
100 plus 273, which is equals to 373 Kelvin.
373.
Kaushik? Yes, sir. 3K.
Very easy from degree Celsius to Kelvin. So when we are converting, when we are converting degree Celsius to Kelvin scale, what we have to do? We need to add, understand, plus 273. That's all. Is it yes or no? Add plus 273.
Yes, sir.
So that, can I write the formula like this? Kelvin scale is equals to degree Celsius plus 273. Is it yes or no, Mari?
Yes, sir.
For example, you take 0 degree Celsius given 0 degree Celsius. Then what is the Kelvin scale? Tell me. I have given 0 degree Celsius. Kelvin scale equals to 273 Kelvin.
Same way,
you tell me. Understanding? Suppose I have given 25 degree Celsius. So in Kelvin scale, can you able to say? Kelvin scale is equals to degree Celsius plus 273. You please add it and tell me. This is what the formula while you are converting from Kelvin scale to
275 degree Celsius.
275 or 25 I have given. So 25 plus 273. How much it is? You add it and tell me. 298. Is it yes or no? Check it. 273 plus,
yes, sir.
5 plus 3, 8, 298 Kelvins. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Mari, do you understand in Kaushik? So this is what? So
yes, when sir, I can understand, sir.
Mari, are you clear, Mari, now?
Yes, sir, I can understand, sir.
When we are converting from understanding degree Celsius to Kelvin, we have to use the formula. Which formula, Mari? Mine should say that Kelvin scale is equals to degree
yes,
Celsius
okay.
273.
Yes,
is it okay, Ra?
Yes, sir, I can understand, sir. Yeah.
Hari, are you clear, Hari? This is the formula. Okay? Now,
sir.
Suppose if reverse, okay. Mari, if suppose reverse, they will ask. If Kelvin scale to degree Celsius, then what we should do? We check it very carefully. Here plus 270.
Degree Celsius is equal to, you have to subtract it, sir.
Subtraction, that's all. So degree Celsius is equals to Kelvin minus 273. That's all. Is it okay, na? This is the
problem. Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah, now observe very carefully. Suppose I have given 300 Kelvin, which is equals to how many degrees Celsius? I have given 300 Kelvin, which is equals to how many degrees Celsius they are asking. So observe very carefully what we have to do. Degree Celsius is equals to Kaushik Sullappa 300, understanding, minus 273. That's all. So which is equals to how much, Ra? 300 minus 273. All of you speak. 10 minus 3, 7. 9 minus 2, 2, 0. So 27 degrees Celsius. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That's it. So 300 minus 273, understanding, 27. Same way, you tell me. Suppose I have given 290 Kelvin. How much faster, tell me? How much it is? Degree Celsius is equals to 296 minus 273. So please do it and tell me fastly. 296 minus 273. So 3, understanding, 2 and 0. So which is equal to how much, Ra?
Sir, 23 degrees.
So 23 degrees Celsius. So I can write here at the last, I can write 296 Kelvin, which is equals to 23 degrees Celsius. Is it yes or no, Mari, Hari, all of you? Do you understanding? Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is what? When we are using these two formulas, you should remember, when we are converting Kelvin scale to, understanding, degree Celsius scale, we have to use minus 273. When we are converting degree Celsius to Kelvin, plus 273. Is it okay, Ra?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Celsius to Kelvin, we have to add plus 273. Is it yes or no? Degree Celsius plus,
yes, sir,
273. Same way, we can make a box. Understand? Kelvin scale to degree Celsius, then degree Celsius equals to Kelvin, understanding, minus 273. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Not at all. This, yes, is the class you must know when we are converting degree Celsius to Kelvin scale and as well as Kelvin scale to degree Celsius. Any doubt, Mari? Hari? No.
No doubt, sir.
We move for next
one. Sir, screen down, sir. Screen down.
Yeah. Okay, Mari.
Yes, sir.
Hari, Kaushik, finish, Rara. Now we will go degree,
yes, sir, finish it, sir.
Degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. Later, degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. Is it okay, Ra? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now, observe very carefully. Mari, shall we start, Mari? So now observe carefully. Degree Celsius scale starts with what? Kaushik, Hari. Degree Celsius scale starts with what? Celsius scale.
0 degrees, sir.
So Celsius scale starts
zero.
Zero degrees and ends with what? 100 degrees. Is it yes or no? Yes or no? Same way. If I take Fahrenheit scale, observe very carefully, it will start with 32 Fahrenheit. How much right is?
32 Fahrenheit.
Understanding, it is also contains 100 divisions. So plus 100 if you add, how much it will come? Plus 100, 212 Kelvin, 212 Fahrenheit. Is it okay, Ra? Degree Fahrenheit. Understanding, Mari, Hari? So, right, yeah, melting point MP of water, understanding, can you able to say, Hari, the 0 degrees Celsius, which is equals to 32 degree Fahrenheit, can you able to say? And as well as boiling point BP of water, which is equals to 100 degrees Celsius, which is equals to 212 degree Fahrenheit.
Sir, can you please tell it again, sir?
Yeah,
my network is very low, sir. Wait a minute, sir.
Scale is starting with a 0 and ending with a 100. Is it yes or no? So each,
yes, sir.
Each division 1 degree. Is it yes or no? Each division 1 degree. Now here, Here also it will Fahrenheit scale starts with the 32 degrees Fahrenheit and ends with the 212 degree Fahrenheit, and also it also contains 100 divisions. So each division is equal to how much? Each division is equal to 1 degree Fahrenheit. Is it okay, Mari? Hari?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
From that you can say water boiling point. Example, I'm saying. So example of water, melting point of MP of water, which is equals to 0 degree Celsius or 32 degree Fahrenheit. And as well as boiling point of water, I can write 100 degree Celsius or 212 degree Fahrenheit. Is it okay, Mari, Hari? Now,
yes,
understand, Mari? So, one degree Celsius means, which is equals to what? 33 degree Fahrenheit. Like same way, 2 degree Celsius means 34 degree Fahrenheit. Like same way, 3 degree Celsius means 35 degree Fahrenheit. So we cannot find every time like this. So we have a formula that while we are finding, understanding, degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. Degree Celsius to what? Degree Celsius to what? Degree Fahrenheit. Or while you are finding degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. So let us discuss. Shall we discuss one? Later you can understand. Is it okay, Mari?
Yes, sir.
Mari? So as
yes, sir.
We are very familiar with the degree Celsius. Is it yes or no? So let us take degree Celsius given, understanding. Given is 10 degree Celsius. Or you can take any value you can take it. Whatever the value you want. So can I take, for example, 50 degree Celsius? Your choice. Anything you can try. Is it okay, Ra? Is it okay or not?
Yes, sir.
Shall we start now?
Yes, sir.
Answer very carefully. So the relationship between, we are converting now what? We want 50 degree Celsius, which is equals to dash degree Fahrenheit. Is it yes or no? Hari, Mari? So now you tell me. We are converting.
Sir.
We are converting from where to where? Degree Celsius to Fahrenheit or Fahrenheit to degree Celsius?
Degree Celsius to Fahrenheit.
So at that situation, so degree Fahrenheit, which is equals to, remember, understanding, 9 by 5. What is this value? 9 by 5 into degree Celsius plus 32. Do you understand, Mari? This is the formula we are using while you are converting from degree Fahrenheit to, degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So what is the formula? All of you read. Degree Fahrenheit is equal to 9 by 5
into degree Celsius plus 32.
When we are converting from degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. Do you understand, all of you? Yes, sir.
Yes.
So now,
sir.
Temperature is 50. Substitute it. Degree Fahrenheit is equals to, Mari, substitute the value. Degree Fahrenheit is equals to 9 by 5 into, what is the Celsius scale given? What is the Celsius scale given?
50 degrees Celsius.
No Celsius, 50 you should write. Plus 32.
Okay, sir.
So now, 5 ones are, 5 tens are. Is it yes or no? Is it yes,
yes sir?
So,
yes, sir.
Degree Fahrenheit is equals to 9 tens are how much? 90. Kaushik plus
32.
90, sir. So add it. How much it will come? 90 plus 32, which will give 212, which is equal to
122. 122, sir. 122.
So I can write, understanding. So how many? So 50 degree Celsius, which is equal to how many degree Fahrenheit? 122.
122.
Mari, do you understanding? Understanding.
So now yes, sir.
What is our body temperature? Can you able to say? What is the human body?
100 degree Celsius. 100 degree Celsius.
100 degree Celsius.
Human body, ra? Human body temperature.
37 degree Celsius.
Which is equals to 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. This is what we have studied. Clinical thermometer.
Yes, sir.
Now, let us verify either it is true or not. So let us take now. Degree Fahrenheit is equals to 9 by 5 into 37, understanding, plus 32. Is it okay, Mari?
Yes, sir.
So now, all of you do division of 37 divided by 5. How much it will come? 37 divided by 5. So you know that 5, 6 are how much?
35.
5, 7 ja. 5 sevens are 35. Is it yes or no? I can give 2.
Yes, sir.
Now, point yes. I can give 0. 5 fours are how much? 5 fours are?
20.
20. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, which is equals to 9 into, can I write how much it is? 5 ones are 5, 7.4s are. Is it okay, Mari? 7.4.
Yes, sir.
Plus, yes, sir. Understanding. So, which is equals to degree for me. Now, multiply these two, please, all of you. Do that multiplication and tell me how much it is. Because we have to do, according to the Bhatmas rule, we should do multiplication first. Is it yes or no? That is what you'll be very careful. So, multiply, tell me. 9 fours are 36. Understanding. Next.
66.6.
66.6 will come. Understanding. So now 66.6 or 66.8? 6 or 8? Okay. So that is. So let us check now. Understanding. 9 fours are how much? 36, 3 is there, 6 is here. Next, 7,
9. 69.8.
You said 66, 69. 69 or 66? 69.8. Yeah,
69.8.
Is it correct?
Yes, sir, correct, sir.
Yes, sir.
How it will come? 9, 7 are how much? Do the division. 9 into 7.4. Mari, you speak. 9 fours are how much? 36. Okay, I can keep here. Next what? Okay, let it be. I will write like this. 36. Next, 7 nines are how much? 7 nines are how much?
63.
Very good. So, I can write 63. So, now, understanding. Point I can keep here. And understanding 3, 3, 6 and 6. So one digit before I can give decimal. 66.6 only. 66.6. Understand, Mari? 66.
Yes, sir.
Plus 32. Hari, it is wrong. 69 is wrong. Understand? Plus 32. You add it and tell me how much it is. 66.6 divided by 32.0. So 6. 628 and 639, 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Is it came or not? Yes or no? Speak, yeah?
Yes, sir.
98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Have you got the answer, Mari? So, which is equals to?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Kaushik, have you got the answer, Kaushik? Mari, Hari, you are very poor in mathematics, sir. That is what? That is why I asked you. First you said correct only. But I repeated so that you are saying wrong. So 9 fours are 36, understanding. And you remember next, 7 nines are 63. And one digit before you have to keep a decimal, 66.6 will come. Is it okay, Ra? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Converting degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. What is the formula? Degree Fahrenheit is equals to, what is that? 9 by 5 into peak degree Celsius plus 32. Yes, sir. No, Hari? Hari?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If I'll give reverse, suppose. Yeah. If we are converting, Mari, remember Hari. So if we are converting degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius, then what will happen? Very simple. From this formula only we are going to get. Observe very carefully. Now we want degree Celsius. Yes, sir, no, Mari? Hari? So
yes, sir.
9 by 5
yes, sir.
Into degree Celsius plus 32. You understanding? This is what my formula. So now from this only I should get. First send this plus 32 this side. What will become Ra? Plus 32 this side, what will become? Minus 32.
Is it sir,
is equal to 9.5.
Sir, can you please tell the formula again?
That is what you see. I am saying, Mari. This is not the formula we know when we are converting degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. Is it yes or no, Mari? Any doubt in this? Degree Fahrenheit equals to 9 by 5 into degree Celsius plus 32. When we are converting from degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit, we have to use this formula. Okay, Hari? Now, we want reverse case. We want convert degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. Then how we should get, you see. So here, plus 32 is there, so that it will come this side. What will become Mari? We want degree Celsius, so that I am keeping this one side and remaining all will come this side. Here plus 32 is there, will come this side. What will become Mari? Plus will become what, man?
Minus.
Subtraction. That is what you should remember. So degree Fahrenheit minus 32, which is equals to 9 by 5 into degree Celsius. Now, here 5 is in division. Will come this side. What will become? 5 is in division. Will come this side. What will become? What will become?
Multiplication.
So 5 into degree Fahrenheit minus 32. All of you should remember, which is equals to 9 into degree Celsius. Now, we want only degree Celsius. So here 9 is extra. 9 is in division. So 9 is in division. Will come this side. What will happen? Oh, sorry. 9 is in multiplication.
Here division. Division.
Will come this side. It will become what? Huh? It will become what?
Division.
Is in multiplication. Will come this side. It will become what?
Sir, division.
Division.
Division, that's all. So 5 into degree Fahrenheit minus 32 divided by 9, which is equal to how much, Mari? Degree Celsius. Is it okay, Ra? Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Second, right, like
yes, sir.
Degree Celsius is equals to, observe very carefully, 5 by 9 into, understanding, degree Fahrenheit minus 32. Both are same. Is it okay? All of you clear? Any doubt, ask me.
Clear, sir.
Yeah. So now, let us go with the reverse case. Now suppose, example, let us verify whether it is correct or not. Understand? So I have given 122 degree Fahrenheit. So verify now, convert it into degree Celsius, all of you. Let me see how you will do. So what we have to do? So degree Celsius, which is equals to 5 by 9 into, understanding. So if you do multiply, what will come, Mari? Degree Fahrenheit, how much it is? 122 minus 32. Is it yes or no, Hari? So 5 by 9.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, 122 minus 32, how much, Ra? 122 minus 32, 0. 12 minus 3, 9. Which is equal to how much? 90. Is it yes or no? Yes?
Yes, sir.
9 tens are. Understanding, which is equals to 5 into 10, which is equal to how much, Ramari, Hari? 50 degree Celsius. Is it yes or no? Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Same thing.
Yes, sir.
Same thing in upper cases, we have solved reverse. Have you remembered? I have given 50 degree Celsius. Here I have given 50 degree Celsius.
And yes,
sir. Fahrenheit. Have you remembered this here, this case? I have given 50 degree Celsius. And we are converting into Fahrenheit. Have you got the same answer or not now? Same answer, have you got the same
yes,
answer?
Sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I hope you don't have any doubt. Are you have doubt, Mari?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir. Sir, on the term you have told that 66.6, that's some, no, sir. For me, answer came as 69.8, sir.
Ray, wrong, Ra. 98.6 Fahrenheit will come. Your multiplication you have done wrong. You just verify multiplication of 1 second, I will teach you. So what is that multiplication, can you able to say, Hari?
Sir, 74 into 9.
74 not, 7.4. 7.4 into 9. Is it yes or no? So forget about
yes,
the decimal. Forget about the decimal. Just normal, sir. 9 fours are how much? 36, correct? Into
yes, sir.
9 sevens are how much?
Yes, sir.
9 sevens 63,
are
how much? Sir.
63.
So that's all. So you add it. 6. 6 plus 6, 3 plus 3, 6 and 6. So one digit before decimal is there. So that one digit before you can give decimal. Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Okay?
So plus 32 if you'll add, plus 32 if you'll add, you will get 98.6 Fahrenheit. Is it okay, Hari?
Yes, sir. Okay,
no
sir.
Confused. Okay.
Yes,
so, Mari, from this, can I conclude degree Fahrenheit equals to degree Celsius? Is it a formula? Do you understand or not? So, while you are converting, observe degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. What is the formula? Kaushik, degree Fahrenheit is equals to speak here 9 by 5 into degree Celsius plus 32. Is it okay, Mari?
Yes, sir.
Whatever we want to calculate, we must keep it in understanding. Right side. Always you should remember. Remaining all should be in left side. Is it okay, Hari? Next, same way, I am making reverse. Understand? Now, reverse case, degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. What is the formula? You speak, I won't speak. So, degree Celsius equals to, this is what should come here. What is the formula? Reverse.
5 by 9 into 5 by 9 into 32.
Do you understand, yes, Hari? You are not supposed to forget it. Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Now, the question is, observe very carefully, understanding. So, when we are converting, also remember always, suppose this is what the conversion we have found it. Is it okay, Mari? Now, suppose I have given degree Celsius, understanding, and I want degree Fahrenheit. We have a direct formula. Is it yes or no? We have
direct. Yes, sir.
Do you understand it? Direct formula. So, suppose when I have given Kelvin scale, I want in degree Fahrenheit. So we don't have a direct formula. Is it yes or no? No direct formula. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
No direct formula. So what we should do means, first we have to convert Kelvin scale into degree Celsius, later degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. Is it okay, Mari? This is what we should do.
Sir, I can't understand.
When they have given degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit, you can directly convert it because we have a direct formula. Is it yes or no? This is the formula we'll use. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Or else, when they have given degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius, we have a direct formula, this is. So we will use this formula. Is it correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But if they have given... Yes. If they have given Kelvin scale, given in a Kelvin scale, and answer should be, understanding, answer must be answer in degree Fahrenheit. So we don't have a direct relation. Is it yes or no? Kelvin scale we cannot convert into Fahrenheit scale directly. Understand, Mari? Understand or not? So what we have to do means Kelvin scale we must convert into degree Celsius first. Is it understanding? Yes or no? Later, degree Celsius we must convert into degree Fahrenheit. Do you want one example for this?